MC, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. The topic today is El Nino La Nina sequel and the palm oil market. It's most appropriate and timely as we have just experienced one of the strongest El Nino recorded in history, and climate condition has now entered the ENSO neutral phase with the possibility of moving into the La Nina territory. As all of you know, weather is one of the key elements in the production and supply of almost all oil seeds and palm oil, and a major catalyst for price movement. How would the transition from a very strong El Nino to either a La Nina or a neutral ENSO condition affect production of palm oil and competing oil seeds, and in turn affect the palm oil market? Today, I shall share with you our thoughts, our insight on the end of the strongest El Nino in history, its impact, and the lingering effect. Is the supply disruption really over? Next, we take a look at the re-emergence, the possible re-emergence of a La Nina towards the end of 2016. We look at the possible impact of La Nina on palm oil and soybean supply. And finally, I will look at the implication of this transition and how it's going to impact palm oil market. Is there a case for further price recovery in 2017, or our palm oil price is going to head south into 2017? 2015 is one, El Nino is one of the strongest in history since the 1900s, equivalent in strength as, if not stronger, than the 1997-98 El Nino. It has disrupted normal rainfall patterns in Southeast Asia, brought widespread and very severe drought to key oil palm growing regions in Southeast Asia. This slide illustrates to you the spread and the severity of the drought on of the El Nino on rainfall pattern in Indonesia and Malaysia. You notice that there is, these are on the line below indicates what we call the severe deficit, water deficit. And you can see here, this is Indonesia, Sumatra. Almost every province have very long drought. Similarly, in Kalimantan, and also in Malaysia, and also in Sabah, Sarawak. Sarawak is least affected, is only a part of the region nearer to the northern Sarawak is affected, but the rest. But what I'm trying to highlight here is this 2015 El Nino drought is actually very, very severe, and it has resulted in what we call an exceptionally long drought. 6 to 11 months of very, very low rainfall, and against what we call a normal 1 to 3 months of low rainfall. And this drought is definitely unprecedented, and it will have lasting and very severe effect on the production of oil palm. I will show to you how bad this El Nino has caused us. Moving on. The severe El Nino caused a very severe impact on the palm tree growth in Indonesia and Malaysia. In my travel in the last one whole year, you see very, what I call, unprecedented and very severe manifestation of this El Nino drought. You can see the oil palm, the growth of the oil palm is delayed due to not opening their leaf for up to a maximum of 8, when we normally have only 1 or 2 unopened leaf. In Because of the drought, it caused massive and widespread front collapse, which I term this as Hawaiian skirt effect. And in very severe case, the whole front collapsed and it led to what we call the sarong effect. And because of this drought, it impacted on the flowering patterns of the oil palm and caused a prolonged male flowering cycle stretching from January right up to July 2016. You see palms with very little crop on the tree, but very, very full of male flowers. This shows to you that the impact of this drought is actually very, very severe, and it has a lasting effect on the... Okay, moving on, the 2015 El Nino drought has already impacted global palm oil production. The impact in the first half of 2016 has been very, very severe. We look at Malaysia, there is a negative in the first half, negative 16% year on year. In Indonesia, because we do not have a national numbers, we took a sample of 12 major companies and look at their first half production, and it shows a 21% drop year on year production. This and the highest obtained during this period was actually 39% drop in yield. Now, because of this severity of the drought, new yield weather benchmarks were established. It is unprecedented. For your information, in East Kalimantan, in 1 month, on a year-to-year basis, we can have a drop of 75% drop in yield. That's to demonstrate to you the severity of this drop. Moving on. Now, at the GAPKI conference in 2015, November 2015, we forecast that Indonesia production will drop by 2.1 million tonnes to 30 million tonnes, and Malaysia production will drop by 0.6 million tonnes to 18.4 million tonnes, giving a total loss of 2.7 million tonnes. Now, and because at that time we say that this is going to be a very major drop in production, and it will trigger a price increase by the first quarter of 2016. All this came true. But when we look at what happened in the first half of 2016 and the establishment of the new, what we call yield weather benchmark, we have to re-look at our forecast. And this is our revised palm oil forecast for 2016. It shows an even sharper decline. The 2015 El Nino is expected now to reduce Indonesia production by 3 million tonnes to 29.1 million tonnes and Malaysian output by minus 2.1 million tonnes to 17.9 million tonnes. Global supply is expected to shrink by 4.9 million tonnes to 57.5 million tonnes instead of a normal growth of 2.8 million tonnes, indicating a colossal supply loss if you add the growth plus the loss of 7.7 million tonnes in 2016. This is definitely unprecedented. And it definitely should have affected our price even more. It represents a negative production growth for the first time in many, many years. The tight supply has actually led to a very strong price rally to date in 2016, besides other demand factors. Is the impact of the strong El Nino really over? The answer is the full impact of the El Nino is not over yet. Supply disruption is going to continue. Our latest forecast shows that we are going to have below normal production to continue in both Indonesia and Malaysia until Q2 2017. Just bear with me a little while because I think today people are all reporting very massive production increase in Kalimantan and Indonesia, but just bear with me a little while. I'm saying, you see, we are going to have a normal production, below normal production until the Q2 of 2017. production will rise in late third quarter of 2016, which is sometime in September, to peak in Q4 2016, which is this next few months. This is what we call a mini recovery in line with the seasonal trend. There is palm goes by season, but the effect is still there. It is going to be below normal. Production in the third Q and fourth Q in 2016 will still be below the same period in 2015. Production will see another sharp decline in the first quarter of 2017 in Malaysia and the second and third quarter in Indonesia because of the lag effect, 24-month lag effect on palm production. The continuing tight supply will limit any anticipated rise in inventories and therefore probably supportive of prices. Moving on, this slide illustrates to you, just point to you, I'm trying to show here, in the first quarter, this is what a normal production should look like, but you are going to get the blue line where you're going to have another big dip, but not as bad as 2016, but you're going to have a very deep, sharp dip. Now, if you look at Indonesia, you can see that actually the first quarter is not so bad, but look at the second quarter. Instead of going up, it's coming down. You're going to have another major, very major or sharp drop in production. And this is going to stretch into the third quarter of 2017. So to round up, this El Nino is not over. I mean, the El Nino is over. The impact is not over. There is a lingering effect until the third quarter, second or third quarter of next year. Now, am I just talking numbers or are the palms telling a story? Sorry, in the last few months and more recently, I've been traveling in different parts of Indonesia and Malaysia, and this slide shows to you very clearly, you have some bunches down here, which is your September, October crop, but look at the male flowers that is coming up on the top, which is going to show to you coming December, January, February, crop is going to come down. And similarly, East Kalimantan, you see the male flower coming out in a very big way. Look at South Kalimantan, and look here, only two, three bunches, and the rest is all male flowers. And in Johor, this is taken in my kebun, my small farm, and you see the massive male flowers coming out, indicating low cropping in January and February. So the weather-based forecast gave us a number that is going to come down very sharply. The field is now telling us that this is going to be a reality. How extensive this is, we will look at it when the time comes. But I'm pretty confident that it's going to be a very another round of what we call supply disruption. Moving on, now let's now take a look a little bit forward. What is going to happen now that we're end of La Nina, and are we going to have the end of El Nino? Are we going to have a La Nina? And what is this transition impact of this transition on the palm oil market supply demand and also supply and also palm oil market? Now, if you look at this, we definitely know that the El Nino has already ended and is already transit or move into what we call the neutral ENSO territory. And now, historically, El Nino is always frequently followed by a La Nina, and it occurred five out of eight times in the last 25 years. So there is a very high probability of it, a La Nina occurring, and most models, however, this time around, most models show that up to now, there is only a 40 to 45% chance of an La Nina occurring by the end of the year. So as the previous speaker said, the La Nina is still uncertain at this stage. The probability of it occurring is significantly lower. That if it does form, it will be a weak and a short-lived La Nina. That's what the expert forecasters are telling us. This is a very classic slide to show to you the very strong El Nino in 2015, which is comparable to the 1997-98, and is coming down. But now we are here, the El Nino is starting, the El Nino index is starting to flatten out. But if you look at the 1997-98, there was a back-to-back El Nino La Nina. It actually caused the La Nina to come down and causing a very severe La Nina. But looking at our trend, it is actually going to flatten out. And it will look more like this 1994-95 El Nino La Nina sequel. So this is to illustrate to you that we are now in what I call an uncharted territory too, very uncertain about the La Nina. The probability is still very low, it's lower, but in weather, we never know. It can just change pretty quickly. So what I'm going to outline to you afterward, we'll look at the different scenarios to see whether at different scenario, what would be the impact on our palm production and supply and market. Moving on, the impact of La Nina on palm oil supply. This is a study we have done, a very classic study. The El Nino result in a yield drop in 2 to minus 23%. But a La Nina following El Nino is very positive for yield. It actually improved the palm oil yield. Why? Because palm oil loves water. When a La Nina came, rain came, and basically it boosts the production up. But even an ENSO, neutral ENSO, was still bring enough rain to boost the production. So if we look at 2017, we are going to have a better production than 2016. But just now, I say that the El Nino drought is going to drag until the second half of 2016. There, you're going to see what is going to happen is you have going to have a major impact on the first half, but the second half, the palm is going to what we receive, what we call a compensatory effect to equalize. So we're going to have very exciting time. Production cycle is going to change because of this after effect of the El Nino. Moving on, La Nina is positive for palm oil yield. La Nina may cause short-term disruption to harvesting and fruit set, but actually it's not very significant. The effect is only normally 1 month or half a month or so, maximum 2 months. But the effect of El Nino is very long because it actually affects inside the palm. Now, while La Nina is more external, historically, a La Nina following an El Nino usually assists in yield recovery. Moving on, La Nina, however, has a much greater impact on competing oil and oilseed production. Historically, La Nina tend to bring hot and drier weather to the key soybean growing region in the Western Hemisphere, particularly in the US, Brazil, and Argentina. Why am I talking about soybean? I will illustrate to you that basically why the price of palm oil goes up after the El Nino, stage one, stage two, the two sequel is a combined effect of one after another that leads to a major rise in price. This slide, according to a study on soybean using USDA data, soybean production declined in 5 out of 6 La Nina in the United States since 1980. And the drop can be minus 3% to minus 20%. Similar observation were observed in part of South America. So a back-to-back moderate to strong El Nino La Nina in Q4 2016 may again disrupt soybean supply in 2017. But as I mentioned earlier, the probability of this occurring at the moment is pretty low. However, if a weak La Nina or an ENSO neutral sequel were to follow, then it will have minimal impact on soybean supply growth. Now, that means we're going to have continued good production of supply of soybean because we already have three bumper crop of soybean in the United States. I think earlier our Chinese speaker and others already show, plus the other member shows that actually soybean has been having good production for the last three major season. And the 2016 is going for another year. Now, that means we're going to have a lot of soybean, but if the palm were to recover in the second half of 2017, we're going to have some very exciting time. What are the implications of the upcoming El Nino La Nina cycle and the palm oil market? Prices are generally cyclical, and major events like El Nino or La Nina can change the supply-demand equations and trigger a major price movement. The 2015 El Nino or Super El Nino has already triggered a moderately strong price rally, or very strong price rally, depending on how you... plus for this, if we look at a monthly Malaysian monthly average from August 2015 to September, the price has actually already increased by 46%. You can see from here right up to here. So will El Nino La Nina sequel push price further up or otherwise? Moving on. Take a quick look at the palm oil inventories. It is still low due to the tight supply from Indonesia and Malaysia. Malaysian product stocks stays at reached 1.4 million in September and in August, and the latest figure shows that it creeped up a little bit to about 1.5 million ton. But our take is probably it will stay below the 2 million ton up, and it might even go lower again in the first quarter of 2017. Indonesia stocks are actually well below the 2 million ton mark, and it's very, very low. From our survey and our travel around, most of the oil mills have very little oil in the tank, and the refineries are actually shouting for oil at one stage. China stock is actually quite low at 0.3 million ton. There is some, whether there's going to be restocking or not will depend very much on the price spread, because they are releasing their rapeseed stocks and also maybe soybean stock. So China import is not very sure, but it depends on other factors. Now, the important point here is the lingering effect of the 2015 El Nino drought is going to cap excessive stock build-up. So therefore, maybe can be maybe positive for prices. Moving on, the impact of La Nina on palm oil prices. As I mentioned just now, the El Nino pushes the price up. Then if it is followed by a La Nina on a back-to-back basis, you see that the prices move up another notch. Very, you can see actually this one, and then it didn't move very much more. This one, it moved up to here, and then the La Nina pushes it up again. Here, move up to here, and then La Nina pushes up here. Here, then La Nina pushes up here. So it is fairly consistent. 5 out of 6 times it happens. So that's why I say El Nino La Nina sequence is actually positive for prices because of its impact on soybean. Therefore, creating what because I look at soybean and palm, because these two combined is actually a major oil contributor in the world. Any disruption on one side, one oil or the other, will have an impact on the overall oil supply. Moving on.
Mr. Ling, sorry, have one more minute. 1 minute, yeah. Please.
Okay. The impact of La Nina on soybean, I've mentioned. So a weak La Nina or neutral ENSO sequel will see a more bearish outlook. This one, I'm not going to talk, it's already soybean. I think biodiesel, domestic biodiesel, basically is just supportive of prices, but not a major catalyst. And I now just like to round up. The strong El Nino has triggered a moderately strong price recovery. It has responded to a sharp decline in production in the first quarter, three quarters of 2016, both in Malaysia and Indonesia, and improving demand. Prices in the BMD has responded aggressively and peaked slightly below 2008 and are up 46% from August 2015. Prices has now retreated to the 2,500 level, although these 2 days it has creeped out a little bit, and may trade sideways and slightly lower within a broad band of 2.7 to 2.4 in fourth Q of 2016 while waiting for fresh catalyst. Now, prices may continue to march north again to 3,000 ringgit per ton as the supply disruption to palm oil by the strongest El Nino resume again in the first quarter of 2017. The extent of further price recovery for palm oil will also have to depend on the possible emergence of a La Nina and its impact on soybean production in the North and South America in late 2016 or 2017. However, this is not going to be a major issue in late 2016 because I think the Americans are already harvesting their crop, and it's going to be predicted that it's going to be a fairly good crop. Now, a close back-to-back El Nino-La Nina sequel will be bullish for palm oil price and competing soybean in 2017. We have two scenarios. Because La Nina is still a little bit uncertain, so I get basically saying that there are two scenarios. One is it will be bullish for price in 2017, but the probability is lower because La Nina is still not very clear. A weak La Nina or neutral ENSO sequel may see a return of robust palm and soybean supply growth, a bearish price outlook, and which is highly probable after the first quarter or second quarter of 2017. On that note, thank you very much for your kind attention.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ling.